viral video of the airport's top smog producer as Boeing 757-200 to A380 crosswind landing goes wrong. Helicopter and other kind of planes landing fails reveals the harsh truth that even the most sophisticated machines are subject to the whims of fate, although it is a realm often hidden from the spotlight. Watch till the end and let us know your thoughts in the comments section. Let's get it on. In this exploration, we'll come in a gripping odyssey into the precarious world of helicopter landing fails, where triumph and disaster are separated by a razor-thin margin. We'll uncover the untold stories of skilled pilots facing unexpected challenges, the hair-raising close calls that push the limits of human endurance. In Eindhoven, Netherlands, this Fairchild C-123 nearly suffers a wingtip strike after landing in strong crosswind conditions. Viral video of A380 crosswind landing goes wrong. This British Airway A380 misses the runway during a landing attempt in strong crosswind. This B-52 Strato Fortress destroys multiple runway edge lights while demonstrating its ability to taxi sideways. This incident occurred during a display at the 2023 Royal International Air Tattoo Air Show. Another Boeing 757-200 freighter almost suffers a tail strike during unusually fast takeoff rotation. And this Delta Boeing 757-300 is forced to go around after the right main landing gear fails to extend.
That can't be.
Yeah, that's not supposed to be the case. I think they're just floating. Oh, I think he popped a tire. Oh, something's wrong. Yeah.
The plane landed and plowed the runway, sending debris flying. Landed too quickly, and engine failure caused the plane to burst into flames on its runway.
Touch it out now.
Oh dear.
Looks like this plane is trying to make an emergency landing during a tornado. It wobbled endlessly and then lost control when it touched the ground. The spectacular landing made this plane completely disappear on the right wing.
Yeah.
Don't forget to press the like button, subscribe, and comment. What do you think of these plane failures? This video, with a crosswind gusting over 40 miles per hour, was no third try, and the plane diverted away. The thing that makes BHX Airport stand out from most other windy airports is the fact that the gusty, turbulent winds seem to persist all the way down to the runway. In most airports, the air seems to be a bit calmer once you enter the ground effect during the flare, but not in BHX. This is caused by a lack of trees or some other specific terrain features in the area, but it makes the landings there quite a bit more interesting. These landings might look scary from the outside. It's a lot more challenging and stressful than landing. Crosswind is from the left, rolling down the mountain. You can see the foliage near the beginning of the tank continuously being pushed to the right. A difficult landing in Madeira Airport. In this video, we'll see a very extreme landing of Boeing and Airbus models in one of the most dangerous airports in the world, the Madeira Airport. Oh my God, those who witness these unique landings call to the airport's top smoke producer. Do you think so? Head landing is how these planes show you when it's off balance and can't actively stop. So poor.
Hola, merde.
Unable to land as usual. The plane bounced up and down two beats before being motionless on the ground. Ethiopia Airline beat the right wing, then beat the left wing to the ground to make the dust fly. Enough of this combo, the plane will continue its journey. Not only can it land on the runway, this plane also wants to show you how exciting it is to land on the sea. The Hudson River is a famous river in the northeastern United States. It flows primarily through the state of New York. The river's course is flanked by picturesque landscapes, including the Catskill Mountains to the west and the Hudson Highlands to the east. On a fateful day on January 15, 2009, US Airways Flight 1549, an Airbus A320, took off from LaGuardia Airport in New York City, bound for Charlotte Douglas International Airport in North Carolina. Shortly after takeoff, the aircraft struck a flock of Canada geese, causing both engines to fail. The pilots, Captain Chesley Sully Sullenberger and First Officer Jeffrey Skiles, found themselves in a dire situation with no engine power and limited options. With incredible skill and composure, the captain made the critical decision to perform an emergency water landing on the Hudson River, as there were no suitable runways nearby for a safe landing. This choice was risky and unprecedented, given that water landings for large commercial aircraft are extremely rare and challenging. In a breathtaking display of airmanship, the captain managed to glide the powerless aircraft onto the frigid waters of the Hudson River, avoiding populated areas and potential casualties on the ground. The flight attendants quickly initiated the evacuation process, ensuring all passengers and crew members safely exited the aircraft and onto the wings to await rescue. Miraculously, every single one of the 155 passengers and crew members on board survived the emergency landing. The event, subsequently dubbed the Miracle on the Hudson, received worldwide attention and praise for the crew's calm and professional response. Siem Reap Province is a culturally rich and historically significant region located in northwestern Cambodia. It covers an area of approximately 3,978 square miles. The provincial capital serves as the primary tourist hub for visitors exploring the Angkor temples. In July 2019, Kinak Dali and Sok Vandi soldiers from the 1st Light Infantry Division in Siem Reap Province, Cambodia, were riding over the crossing made from logs and mud when it gave way due to the force of the river below. They get two-thirds of the way across before it collapses, sending them falling into the water. They both plunge some 10 feet into the torrent of water. The terrifying scene of the flood made everyone think of a sad ending. But no, by quick wits and unexpected luck, these two guys were able to cling to a tree branch by the river and survive thanks to the soon help of people around. Don't forget to press the like button, subscribe, and comment what do you think of these amazing moments. Spencer Glacier is situated in the Kenai Mountains within the Chugach National Forest in south-central Alaska, US. It's part of the Chugach National Recreation Area, a popular destination for outdoor enthusiasts. Dramatic video captured the moment of a series of ice structures collapsing, creating a huge wave that sent the two kayakers fleeing. They are Andrew Hooper and Josh Bastier. They embarked on an adventurous journey on a fateful Saturday, August 10th. As Andrew and Josh paddled cautiously through the icy waters, they marveled at the immense glacier towering above them. The tranquility of the moment was interrupted by the distant rumbling of ice. Before they could react, a deafening roar echoed through the valley. A massive section of the glacier broke off, thundering into the lake below with an incredible force. Waves surged violently, and the icy waters churned as the kayakers found themselves in the midst of a natural catastrophe. Fear gripped Andrew and Josh as they desperately paddled away from the surging ice and water, and survival instincts kicked in. Andrew and Josh navigated their kayaks with every ounce of strength they had, dodging ice chunks and powerful waves that threatened to capsize them. Finally, the two kayakers managed to reach the safety of solid ground just in time with sheer determination and a stroke of luck. Don't leave the screen. There are many other fascinating scenes that continue to help you better understand these events. Being struck by lightning is an incredibly rare and dangerous phenomenon, as lightning bolts can carry millions of volts of electricity. However, there have been instances where individuals miraculously survived after being struck. In 2013, Violet de Mello, a British tourist, was on a safari in Zambia when she was struck by lightning. The bolt struck her hair, but she managed to survive without severe injuries. Or Roy Cleveland Sullivan, known as the Human Lightning Rod. Roy Sullivan was a park ranger in Virginia, USA, who holds the Guinness World Record for being struck by lightning the most times, 7 times between 1942 and 1977. Despite the numerous strikes, he survived each one, though he did suffer various injuries such as burns and hearing loss. These stories of survival serve as rare and astonishing examples of human resilience in the face of nature's most powerful forces. A Missouri teenager's TikTok has gone viral for capturing her car's terrifying plunge into floodwaters. Soon-to-be college freshman Catherine Kay was driving to her boyfriend's house close to 2 a.m. when she drove into a flood zone. As water started gushing into her car, Kay began recording and soon abandoned the vehicle. The current carried her away from the submerged vehicle, and she fought to keep her head above the water. She gasped for air as the water seemed to pull her under. Desperate to stay afloat, Lily spotted a sturdy tree just a few yards away. Summoning her last ounce of strength, she swam toward it and clung onto its branches with all her might. The tree became her lifeline in the raging flood. Finally, rescuers waded through the floodwater, reaching out to her with a lifeline for an hour waiting for rescue.
It's coming out of the creek over there. It's overflowing the creek and coming in. That creek from Alum.
Yeah, from Alum.
Spain is situated on the Iberian Peninsula, sharing borders with Portugal to the west and France to the northeast. It's surrounded by the Atlantic Ocean to the northwest and the Mediterranean Sea to the east and south. High above the picturesque landscape of the Spanish countryside, paraglider named Alex embarked on what he expected to be a thrilling adventure in the skies. With the wind beneath his wings and the sun on his face, he soared gracefully, feeling a sense of exhilaration and freedom that only flying could provide. Little did he know that this day would become a true test of courage and resilience. As Alex glided through the air, marveling at the breathtaking views below, he noticed a subtle change in the feel of his paraglider. Panic began to rise within him when he realized that something was amiss with his parachute. Frantically pulling on the cords, he desperately tried to open it, but to his horror, the parachute remained stubbornly closed. He scanned the landscape for a safe landing spot, but the ground below was a patchwork of forests and rocky terrain. Despite the pain, Alex remained conscious and knew that his ordeal was not over yet. With determination in his heart, he decided to aim for an open field he spotted in the distance. The ground rushed up to meet him, and the impact was harsh, jolting his entire body. Like a miracle, he escapes death. Bless him. Costa Rica is located in Central America, bordered by Nicaragua to the north and Panama to the south. It's situated between the Pacific Ocean to the west and the Caribbean Sea to the east. Last year, a DHL cargo plane skidded off the runway in Costa Rica. Among the various aircraft preparing for takeoff or touchdown, a DHL cargo plane stood tall, its engines roaring with power. As the DHL cargo plane approached the runway, the winds picked up, creating an unforeseen challenge for the pilots. The aircraft swayed, and the captain had to make quick adjustments to maintain control. Despite their best efforts, the plane made a rough touchdown, jolting the entire aircraft and causing it to skid off the runway. Inside the cargo hold, the valuable packages and goods shifted and bounced with the impact. The challenging conditions had led to the skid and eventual breakage of the aircraft. As the dust settled, the extent of the damage to the aircraft became evident. The DHL cargo plane had broken in half, the fuselage separating from the main body. It was a distressing sight, but captain and co-pilot knew they had done everything they could to prevent a more catastrophic outcome. Thank goodness pilots are safe. And it's not a passenger plane. Don't leave the screen. There are many other fascinating scenes that continue to help you better understand this natural world.
Thank you for watching the video. If you feel it's good, please feel free to click the subscribe button to receive more interesting videos. See ya.